Hello, my name is Kurian. I come from Kerala. So I am a third year student in Model Engineering College. I'm a contributor in Cloud CV. So today I'm here to talk about the official website of which was used for Kerala rescuing when the floods, bad floods happened during the August. So I'm here to talk about that website. Can we go to the next website? Next slide. Can you please? Can you just play that video in the previous slide? So this is a small video about how the floods were affected in Kerala. So as you can see, almost the entire state, like almost the 40% of our state were flooded during Kerala, during the bad floods which happened. Almost 35 dams were opened during the floods, and a lot of people were stranded. And as you can see, people are looking for rescue. And also, the government had no mechanism to coordinate all the requests from anything. There were landslides in the hilly regions, and as you can see that, and also about 320, this is just an earlier figure, about 480 people died during Kerala floods. And also the thing was, there was no platform for rescue or something. The government had a huge challenge, because no one thought that floods will happen at that time, because people were thinking that it was just rains. It usually happens because Kerala is a tropical country, tropical place. But all of a sudden, all the 35 dams were opened because of deadly floods. As you can see, people's houses being flooded till the second floor or something. So can we go to the next slide? So as you can see how deadly the Kerala floods was. So about 483 people died in Kerala floods, and we had an estimated loss of about 14,000 crores to our economy. Next slide, please. So these are some of the pictures which capture the gravity of the exact situation during Kerala floods, which happened during that time. And it was the worst floods which had happened in the past 100 years in Kerala. Next slide. So this is the official website which was used for rescuing, and the good thing is it was entirely open source, and it was developed by a set of open source contributors who were mainly students. So there were various features, like the people could rescue for people could ask for requests, like requests for help, like people could ask for food items, people could ask for rescuing by airplanes or something. And all these were coordinated by this website, and government was using this data. There was missing persons feature so that people could find if they were there. Then all the relief camps. We had about 5,500 plus relief camps, which was run solely by the government, and also more relief camps which were run by private parties like schools, colleges, etc. So all these relief camps were coordinated in the site. Then there were, so Kerala is a state with 16 districts. So all the districts, the collectors requested the needs of that places through this thing, so that people could contribute like this. You could have registered as a volunteer or something. Then there was a maps feature. So what this maps feature did was, like, you could see where the people were stranded exactly. So for example, if you, I am actually a person living in a place called Kochi. So if I wanted to rescue someone which is nearby my locality, I can go myself. So almost, actually government didn't do all the rescue. Actually fishermen did the rescue, people like us, local people did the rescue. So this website helped in understanding where the people needed rescue, and there were registered requests. So government would not be able to provide all the time the requested help. So what people did was, local people came there, came to places, give food item, give toiletries, and all those things. Next slide, please. So I'll just say a bit about this. So
you've got about 60 seconds.
Okay. So we started in in August 11th. During that time, the floods was not so severe. So a set of volunteers developed the initial site in August 11th. Then the situation got worsened. Kerala government tried to make a site, but since IEEE, since already a set of open source contributors had already made the site, so government of Kerala decided to make this as an official platform. Next slide, please. So this was the initial slide. This was how the website was in August 11th, and you can check the current website for how it is. Next slide, please. So this is the exact scale of how Kerala Rescue operated. We had about 15,000 requests for help, and all the individual people didn't apply, families applied for them. So maybe about 10 lakh or 20 lakh people were covered. We had 5,500 relief camps, as I said. Next slide, please.
Okay, you're at time, but okay. If the next speaker's not here, I don't see a problem with running. Is Kapil Chowdhury really not in the room? Really not? Okay, keep going.
Okay. So this is Biswas, who is the lead developer of Kerala Rescue. So he said, this is a famous talk which he gave in PyCon India. So Python and open source rescued Kerala during this during the deadly floods. So he will be giving a talk regarding this in International PyCon in US. So if you are there, go and say hi to him. Next slide. So this is the entire team which worked on. There are not some open source contributors there, because we had a variety of people, like people from Finland, people from Australia, all contributing to this project. So there were a set of government workers in our team. We had a bunch of students. We had a bunch of American entrepreneurs who came just for this and who helped us during this flood. Next slide.
Is my seat. Front row, please.
And this is the last link. If you want to read the blog about what it is, you can read At the Eye of the Flood, which is an article written about KerlaRescue.in. And you can also see the YouTube video in which Biswas gave a lightning talk in PyCon India. Thank you. That's all.